Best wishes to all of you. Welcome to Meet Me, Party Roseate, on the Perros Cement Techno Channel. On this occasion, we would like to share knowledge about cement technology, especially about the cement production process, starting from the mining process, raw material milling process, combustion process, coal milling process, cement milling process, and cement packing process. This video specifically explains the cement production process flow, and for videos of the cement production process for other units, you can visit the Perros Cement Techno channel, which has several videos that we have finished making. Watch this video until it's finished, so you can fully understand the flow of the cement production process. Cement production process flow. The main raw material of cement is 80% limestone, and other raw materials are clay, silica sand, and iron sand. The cement production process flow consists of 5 stages of the process, including 1. Mining process. 2. Process of milling raw materials into raw flour. 3. The process of burning raw flour into clinker. 4. Process of milling clinker and additive material into cement. 5. Cement packing process. Mining process. In this mining process, there are several activities, including land clearing, which is cleaning trees and soil layers, drilling, namely drilling to insert explosives, blasting, namely blasting limestone mining material according to the desired production amount, and is carried out during the day at 12 a.m. Hauling, which is the process of transporting mining materials to the crusher using wheel loaders, excavators, and dump trucks. Crushing is a process to reduce the size of mining material that is still large in size from more than 500 millimeters to less than 50 millimeters. Then the limestone material from the crusher is sent to the storage plant using overland belt conveyor and filling the material into the storage using a stacker belt conveyor, which can be adjusted so that the material of varying quality can be mixed well or homogeneously, and is called the pre-blending process. The next process is the raw material milling process. Limestone material and corrective material clay, silica sand, and iron sand are put into the feeding bin, which is prepared for feeding to the raw mill system. Then the materials of limestone, clay, silica sand, and iron sand, with a predetermined composition, are entered simultaneously to the raw material milling process, to a certain fineness or 12 to 14% on 90 micron. Some of these raw material milling equipment use a tube mill and some use a vertical roller mill. In the milling process, this raw material requires hot gas for drying the material in the system to reduce the water content from more than 10% to less than 1%. The hot gas for drying in the raw mill system is taken from the hot gas remaining from the combustion in the kiln system. Then the hot gas remaining from the process in the raw mill system, which is still mixed with dust, is filtered first in the dust collector, then the clean air is discharged out into the free air through the chimney. While the product from the raw mill system milling process, in the form of raw meal, is inserted into the silo, and in the silo blending occurs when it is inserted, and there is also aeration at the bottom of the silo, when it is removed for feeding to the kiln system. The next process is the combustion process. Raw meal from the silo is fed to the kiln system using a bucket elevator to the feeding bin, then the raw meal through the scales to adjust the amount of feeding is entered into the topmost cyclone preheater system. In this preheater system, several processes occur, including drying process, separation process, heat transfer process, and decarbonization process, or the process of decomposing CaCO3 into CaO+CO2. CaO is contained in the processed material, while CO2 evaporates with the exhaust gases. Then after the above process, the material from the lowest cyclone enters the rotary kiln, where the temperature inside is between 1100 to 1500 degrees Celsius. In the rotary kiln, the material undergoes a clinker formation process, including chemical and physical reactions, chemical reactions between C4AF, C3A, C2S, C3S, and a physical reaction in the form of a granular called clinker. Furthermore, the clinker from inside the rotary kiln, whose temperature is still high or around 1200 degrees Celsius, enters the cooler system, where the cooling is taken from the outside air using several cooling fans. Cooler systems used in general are grate cooler, crossbar cooler, and planetary cooler. In this cooler, the clinker is cooled to below 100 degrees Celsius. Next, the clinker from the cooler is put into the clinker silo using an apron conveyor. The heat used for the combustion process in the rotary kiln system comes from the main burner and calciner burner with coal or fine coal as fuel. Fine coal or fine coal is obtained from the coal milling process or the coal mill system. The next process is the cement mill, or the process of grinding clinker into cement. Clinker from the silo is put into the feeding bin, then added with gypsum material, an additive material with a predetermined composition, entered into the grinding mill system simultaneously until a certain fineness according to the type of quality of the desired cement product, or according to the type of cement produced. There are three types of milling equipment used in the cement grinding process, including, using tube mill and pre-grinder, using a vertical roller mill. In the cement grinding process, it is also equipped with a dust collector to catch the dust carried by the air in the grinding process. The captured dust is put back as a product, while the clean air exits through the chimney into free air. Then the cement product from the milling results is put into the cement silo as the final cement product. The last process is cement packing. In this packing system, there are two types of cement production, namely bag cement and bulk cement. Seaman bag 40 kg and 50 kg using a rotary packer, and how to attach the bag to the spout packer, some are automatic and some are still manual. Then the cement bags are arranged on pallets and put into the warehouse or arranged directly on the bed of the truck that will transport them. For big bag 1000 kg and big bag 1500 kg, use special big bag scales, and usually this is for special orders or requests from consumers. Meanwhile, bulk cement is transported using bulk trucks or directly loaded onto bulk cement transport vessels using pneumatic conveying directly. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and see you in the next video.